Hello, I'm Mr. Onigiri, retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist and not a theologian who went to the university to study the dead letters and turned out to be a super donkey carrying holy books. And these university professors, they teach the dead letters. The interpretation of the parable, they say it is not their job, but that of their student to do it, which is right. So gospel is by the grace of our supernatural Father. But once you get drunk with the old wine of the dead letters at the universities and colleges, you desireth not the new. So they are dead, spiritually dead people in the universities. I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. So here I'm telling you that in Orthodox churches, you see the icons of Christ Jesus and the apostles, and they have put Bibles in their hand. Now Bible, they are letters, scripture, which is forbidden by Jesus. It is the Jewish leaven. That's why Jesus said, when you go on a preaching tour, don't take any money in your pocket. No two shoes, no two tunic. Or script. Script means scripture, Bible is forbidden. Because our covenant of the letters, law and letters, in which you have sin, transgression against the moral law is sin, used to be with the rabbi when they were efficient. But when they became crook and hypocrites, then Christ Jesus come to introduce to us our supernatural Father, which is, you cannot see with the two naked eye, but is known to you by the third eye of logical reasoning. How you perceive, no more seeing but perceive. And that is called oral Torah. And here is the presentation of that one. So this, the top is the scripture. This is scripture. Scripture you see. An ideal rabbi is defined by Matthew 13 verse 52. He is the owner of a house, synagogue, who bringeth forth treasures, old, this is the old treasures, and the new, which is the gospel, oral Torah. Oral Torah is in fullness, it lacks nothing, but this lacks oral Torah. Without oral Torah, this tree is dead. You can see if the root is dead, how can the tree be green? Among the Samaritan and Gentile, this oral Torah was there. And their tree, moral laws, they were written over their heart, and not in the dead letters of the books. So Christianity is of the heart, and not of the dead letters, but of the heart in fullness. This is oral Torah. Perceive, this is you perceive. That's why Jesus said, they see the dead letters, but not they perceive the origin of the dead letters, the root of the word dead letters. So putting, that's why St. Paul said the gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart. So here is the two kingdoms. So here is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis in law and order. And the last, and among the rabbis are the prophets. So last prophets were John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So they end, this thing ends. And Jesus come in to bring in the royal kingdom of God, which is not outside, but in your own heart. So when he proclaimed the kingdom, then the temple priest exploited the word kingdom, that he is a king. And to the Pilate he told them, hey, this is, he proclaimed himself to be the king, but we like you to be the king. So when Pilate asked Jesus, what is the truth? They are telling you that you are the king. Jesus said, if my kingdom was of this outside, my soldiers would have come to fight against yours, but mine is within my own heart. And when Pilate understood it, remember Jesus asked Pilate, is this question you are asking me, is originating from you, from your own heart, or somebody else told you? Then Pilate retorted, do you think I'm a Jew? So your people are telling that you are the king. And when he understood it, you know, what the truth, then he told them he had done nothing wrong. But they shouted and they want to kill him and get the robber to be released. And then he put the plaque that Christ Jesus has been proclaimed king by the Jews and not by anybody else. So that's why he put the king of the Jews plaque on it and sent him to the temple to do the justice according to his own law. And he himself washed his hand under sun, the primary source of light, that have nothing to do with the blood of this honest man. So that's how Jesus was killed, you know, shouting. So this is the time of this royal kingdom, and this time is gone. So anybody who talks about sin in a church, or put a statue or icon of anything, they are antichrist. Remember Paul and Silas, when they told in the town, I don't remember the name of the town, that these statues and all these, that time has gone. We should worship God in truth and in Holy Spirit. John 4. And then the local people, artisans, they were not happy. So they beat them and they took them to the court, local man, and they put them in the jail. And they were stoned, you know. They almost died. And in the jail, when they were singing the praises of our supernatural Father, then all those who were bound, and they lent their ears to hearing what came out of the mouth of St. Paul, all were set free. That means people in the jail, they are better than people in the town who are money worshippers. Oh dear. Hello? 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 Yeah. Huh? What's your name? Oh, Mrs. Ball. Okay, I will tell the wife. You want to speak with my wife? Yeah, hold on. Hello? Ah, my camera, get out of the room. Oh dear. Okay, sorry for the disturbance. So our covenant with Christ Jesus is of Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters, scripture, the Bible. So Bible is forbidden by Christ Jesus, because the gospel gets written over your heart. From your own heart you have to preach gospel, not at looking at the book, what it says. Anybody looking from the book, they are spiritually blind. And those people in the churches which has icon and all those statues, they are antichrist. Remember how Paul and Silas were beaten to death for opposing those icons. And there you are, you put them in the churches. St. Paul said the gospel cannot be written on ink on paper, and there you are. You put Bible in his hand. So spiritually blind people are many. Those who are alert to Holy Spirit, they are few. And they mock at them. So here is our covenant with the of Christ Jesus in Holy Spirit. So the covenant of law was still John the Baptist. He baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Christ Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. And they were solitary of Holy Spirit, and they were seeking this narrow gate. So to enter this one, you have to graft yourself to the true vine. You can't graft if you are a seed. You have to turn the seed into plant. So your tribal seed, son of Abraham, salt of the earth, is to be sown into the ground, or the ego is to be destroyed and turned into plant, and that plant is twice born. So far you have seed, you are once born. That I am white man, black man, yellow and this color. So that's why St. James the Just was telling them, in Christ Jesus, there is neither Jew nor Gentile, we are all the same. But the Jewish rabbis, who were very proud of being the sons of Abraham, to whom they were unfaithful, saltless, they sent people to kill him when he was doing so on the Passover, and killed him. So you have to be careful, you have to be of discerning intellect to know gospel. So people of discerning intellect, they enter this narrow gate, and here you are twice born, and you graft yourself to the true vine. Here your soul is concerned, not your physical body. Here your physical body is concerned. That is the seed. No son of man, no son of God. So that's why here your soul represents our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So you are the son of the Most High, and we are fishers of men and no more women. That's why St. Thomas said, unless a female is here, obeying the rabbi, anybody you follow, then you become a female. When you become independent, then you are a male, master of your own destiny. Unless a female becomes a male, solitary, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. So here neither male, not female, not Jew, not Gentile, but the sons of the Most High, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Our soul is concerned, which is the same in a black man, in a white man, in a dog, elephant, anything. So here we exercise love called agape, and here arrows, tribal love, arrows, which Moses created. This is on international basis. This is on national basis. much more. You can see it on my videos. And so with this background and this one, you know, which is the, tell me the menorah, this, these parts are created by Yahweh. Social, ecumenical, political affairs, secular affairs. Spirituality comes from our middle candle of God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So the soul comes from our supernatural Father in everyone, whether he is good or evil. So that's why in Christianity we hate none. We love everyone in agape. Agape, unconditional divine love. You turn your other cheek. But in this one, in Yahweh, jealous and revengeful, you beat them. And Jesus made a whip and turned the traitors out of the court of his heavenly Father Yahweh. That was in the name of Yahweh, he, jealous and revengeful. And this is not jealous and revengeful, it's ever loving. It is all positive qualities, no negative qualities. So with this, much more you can learn, you know, if you are interested. This is the book I have written. You can find it on internet. So here is something I have written and I just go through. Our covenant with Christ Jesus is of the Holy Spirit, of the living Holy Spirit. Common sense. Common sense is ever living because it is a gift from the God. Our God is living, so is common sense living. And not of the dead letters. Dead letters that you study the book and you, as in the universities people do, they don't care about God. What they know, have this book knowledge. And that is all they call gospel and everything. Whatever their teacher tells them, they just vomit it out. So they are orphans to their book and to their teacher. Without book, they can't utter a single word. While those who possess the Holy Spirit, as the Gentile and the Samaritan did, they speak, their laws are written over their heart. So they don't need book. So that is gospel. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16, and not with Jesus. Gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablets of heart, through logical reasoning that brews logo, and logo is his word. Spiritually dead disciples of Rabbi, spiritually dead disciples of the Rabbi, they go by the book, you know what is written. Go by the dead letters, and without the Bible in their hands, they cannot speak a word. They are orphan. Without Bible, they are orphan. But with the power of the Holy Spirit, we can preach the gospel from our own hearts, called drinking the blood of Christ. Remember, Jesus said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus, what came out of the mouth of Jesus, yeah, this ear is the mouth. You take it to your heart, digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning, and then you preach gospel from your own heart, and not what this book say or that book say or this book. You don't follow Jesus. We don't, for blind people, follow Jesus. We join hands with Jesus. We are supporters of Jesus. We are not followers of Jesus. Scriptures are milk for the once born babies. When you are a small boy, you know, you study scripture, and that is beneficial. Whilst the flesh of Jesus for the twice born, capable of logical reasoning. So with short this video, I hope you understand. There are many videos I have put down. But gospel is by the grace. So unless you get gospel, unless you get Holy Spirit and make use of it, you are dead and useless, and you have become a fanatic. But in Holy Spirit you are not fanatic. You listen to everyone. What is good you keep, what is bad you throw it away. And the fishermen sort their fish after the catch. What is good they keep, what is bad they throw it back into the sea. Our Father God blesses you in agape, unconditional divine love.